companies such as Google, Amazon, Facebook, Apple, Tesla, Twitter, etc. They always have job postings available, having a six-figure salary as an intern. That's completely mind-blowing. Hi everyone, this is Mika Kim. Welcome to part two of What to Expect as a Student at the University of Waterloo. To give a quick intro about myself, I graduated in 2017 with a Bachelor of Mathematics, and after graduation, I worked as a consultant for one of the big four consulting firms, and currently I'm a software engineer in the US. In this video, I will tell you everything you need to know about Waterloo's co-op program. If you haven't done so already, go check out part one of my video where I talk about Waterloo's academics, reputation, school life, etc. And I will link that in the description box below. First, I will go over what the co-op program is, how it works, then go into the juicy topic of what kind of jobs you can get and how much money you can make. Also, as a student that went through this process 5 times, I will go over the list of pros and cons of this co-op program. As a quick disclaimer, since I am working in the tech industry right now, a lot of my stories may be biased towards that field. So let's get started. If you're interested in applying to the University of Waterloo, you must have heard of Waterloo's co-op program. So what exactly is a co-op? To quickly explain it, it's a 4-month internship that you apply to, but through job postings that are only available to Waterloo students. Based on your program, you'll go through about 4 to 6 co-op terms, which means you will have 4 to 6 internships already under your belt by the time you graduate. If you think about it in another way, it means you have up to 2 years of work experience before graduating. Now that's insane. The benefits of having this experience is astronomical, and I will go over why in a bit, so stay tuned. All right, let's quickly go over how the co-op program works. The first couple of steps is pretty similar to how you would apply to any other job. Around the 2nd to 3rd week of each semester, jobs get posted through an internal Waterloo website called Waterloo Works. Companies that have signed up through Waterloo's hiring process will start posting their jobs there. Before the end of the following week, you will have to go through all the job postings that's in Waterloo Works and apply to all the companies that you're interested in. The caveat here is per cycle, you only get 50 applications in total. So even if there are 60 jobs you're interested in, you can only apply to 50. After a week or so, if you have been selected for an interview, you will get notified. Most of the times, interviewers come to Waterloo, and interviews are generally held in a place called the Tatum Center, which looks like this. Now this is awesome because you don't have to budget time and money to go travel to another city for your interview. For instance, if you had to go to Toronto to go take your interview, you'd have to budget at least half a day and miss your classes to do that. Now this whole interview period may last up to 2 weeks, and around a day or so after the whole interview cycle has ended, companies will rank their interviewees, and students will also rank the companies that they have interviewed with. This ranking system is very unique to Waterloo, and so I will explain how the ranking system works in a bit. The next day, you will get the ranking results and find out what company you matched with. And generally, you can think of this as a full cycle. Based on if you got matched with the company or not, there are subsequent cycles that come up, and with each cycle, you get 50 more applications. So let's go into how ranking works. Let's say Yelp posted a job for a software developer role, and I applied. Yelp decides to interview 5 out of their 300 applicants. Lizzie, Andy, Steve, myself, and Wendy. During the ranking period, Yelp will give an offer to one person and rank the other students with a number from 2 to N. They also have an option to not rank someone if they don't want to hire them at all. This result will get revealed to all the students. Now, since students may have interviewed with more than one company as well, they can also rank the different companies they interviewed for. And your match gets determined based on the minimum number for that role. So what does that really mean? Okay, let's go back to the example. Let's say Lizzie got an offer, I got ranked number 2, Andy 3, and Steve and Wendy did not get ranked because Yelp didn't want to hire them at all. If Lizzie also ranks Yelp number 1, it's a guaranteed match. But let's say Lizzie got another offer from Tesla, and she ranks Tesla number 1. Then she will get matched with Tesla instead of Yelp, because she would have to give Yelp a bigger number than 1. Now let's say I got some other ranks and offers too. I got an offer from KPMG, but I really want to go to Yelp. Then I can strategize it like so. I will give Yelp number 1, and I can give KPMG number 3. So that increases my chances of getting matched with Yelp over KPMG. Because if the number is the same, let's say I gave KPMG a 2 and KPMG gave me a 1, which equals to 3, I give Yelp number 1 and Yelp gave me number 2, then that's also a 3. So the numbers are the same now, then it's a toss up. And based on a random number that gets assigned, you will get a job matched. So this ranking system does have a bit of an element of gambling based on how the other students rank companies, which makes this a little bit more sophisticated. I know this is a bit confusing, so if you need any more clarification, please leave a comment below and I will answer your question. Now for the golden question. What kind of job postings are available and how much money can you make? There are all sorts of jobs and positions from industry-leading companies. For all of you in tech, companies such as Google, Amazon, Facebook, Apple, Tesla, Twitter, etc. They always have job postings available. For those of you interested in audit or consulting roles, Deloitte, EY, PwC, KPMG, all of them also have postings every semester as well. And the same goes for other industries as well. I'm really sorry I couldn't come up with any company names because they're not the industry of my expertise, but I do have friends in different fields, such as civil engineering and chemical engineering, that were also able to find great jobs from reputable companies in their respective fields. Now let's talk about money. So how much money can you actually make? Can you make enough to cover your tuition? Well, let's take a look. Waterloo has a chart posted publicly online every year for average co-op earnings based on program and year. So let's look at the Canadian work terms. I'll use math as the example since that was my program. If you look at the first work term, you can see an average of $19.34 per hour rate. That is pretty solid given the minimum wage rate of $14 in Ontario based on 2021 rates. And having this as your first co-op job as a first year, that's not too bad. The cool thing is, based on how desirable of a candidate you are, and also if you're successful in negotiating, this value can be much, much higher. And of course, as your year and experience goes up, your wage will go up as well. Now, here's the fun part. Let's take a look at what US work term salary looks like. You can see here for the sixth co-op term, it's an average of $46.80 USD and a high of $70 USD per hour. $70 per hour to salary is $145,600. That means having a six-figure salary as an intern. That's completely mind-blowing. I will link the co-op earning website in the description below, so please feel free to take a look at this in your free time and do the math yourself. Now, I will be super honest, these high-paying US jobs are going to be very, very competitive. But there is a definite possibility that you can land these roles yourself as well. This uplift that you get is unique to Waterloo, which I think is really cool. All right, so let's talk about the advantages of the co-op program. So let me state the obvious. You get to work in six different jobs before graduating, and that is huge. So let me explain that a little bit. First of all, you get to try out all these different roles at different companies with no strings attached. For instance, let's say you are interested in becoming a project manager and you do a co-op term at Microsoft as a PM. You realize PM is not really the career path that you want to take. So the next co-op term, you work at Facebook as a software developer. And after this, you realize you love the job, but not the company. Next, you work for another co-op term at Amazon as a software dev. And ding, 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 you found your match. Being able to go through this process of exploration this early in your career is a huge, huge advantage. By the time you graduate, you will have a much more solid understanding of what traits of a job or a company is the right fit for you. Imagine having to go through this process as a full-time. You can't expect yourself to jump between different companies and different roles every 4 months that easily. Next, co-op experiences prepare you for professional skill sets. I have seen a ton of new grads with no internship experiences that get their first job and not know how to write a professional email. I'm not trying to say that is wrong, but imagine how ahead of the crowd you will be by going through six internships already. Also, you have the opportunity to network with so many different people in these different internships, which will all be valuable connections later down your career. Number three, your co-op terms have a high possibility of connecting to full-time. After completing a successful co-op term, a lot of the times the company will give you a return offer as a full-time. That means you will have a job lined up already with a company that you're already familiar with. So no need to stress out of having to scramble through your fourth year trying to find a job. Number four, Waterloo makes this process a bit more uniform. Like I mentioned earlier, your application, your interviewing period is all predetermined and won't be all over the place. Another advantage is most of the times interviewers will come to the school. No need to travel. And finally, you get to make some money while you're in school. Personally for me, I never had a very high paying US job when I was a co-op student. So with the amount of money that I made through my co-ops, I wasn't able to pay off school or anything, but I was able to live a very comfortable lifestyle during school without having to get any support from my parents or without having to do any part-time jobs. So now let's go over the disadvantages of the co-op system. Juggling through studying and job applying is so arduous. As if exams and assignments and quizzes and all of these things weren't hard enough. On top of that, every semester you have to go through this job finding process. Whenever interview period rolls around, I used to have sleeping problems and felt so antsy and nervous all the time. Also, interview period always overlaps with midterm period. I said this during my other video, but I had this instance where my midterm exam and my co-op interview was like almost kind of overlapping. So I had to rush through my midterm, submit it, and sprint to Tatum Center to take my interview. And all of this combined together really does take a toll on you. Number two, unfortunately, you will have no summer breaks. So being in a co-op program allows you to go through a four-year degree with 2 years of work experience. So 4 plus 2 is 6, but if the whole co-op program takes 5 years, where's that extra 1 year from? So instead of having summer breaks like a lot of other students, you're basically filling up that time with your co-op term. So high chances you won't have any official long breaks during your 5 years at Waterloo. This does make me a little sad time to time when I hear of these amazing traveling stories that happened during summer break from my other friends that went to other universities. Number three, the ranking system may set you back. Like I mentioned when I was describing how the ranking system works, based on how these numbers are matched and kind of like the jumbling through of the matching process, you might actually get matched with the company that you did not want to go to. So because of that luck and gambling aspect of things, it might put you at a disadvantage, but that's not too common, so don't worry too much about it. Number four, comparing. Honestly, I feel like the co-op process promotes a bit of a toxic culture amongst the students at Waterloo. You will quickly realize that a lot of people will gloat about the amount of money they're making and what kind of companies that they have been matched with for their co-op terms. And this will make you fall into the trap of comparing yourself to others. Please, please, please remember, a single co-op term will not determine the long-term success of your career. I've had that happen to me too. I've also been through comparing myself, being super depressed, but it's not worth wasting your time on. Please take my word for it. Maybe during this particular co-op term, your friend is making more money than you. Maybe your friend is going to cooler places at a seemingly cooler role, but no one knows what the future has in store for you. So stop beating yourself about it. Honestly, this would kind of be my mental note to my past self. I personally didn't have any US high-paying co-op jobs as a student, and at the time, I was really ashamed of it. Looking back to all of my co-op terms, I've learned so much from every single one of them and also met so many valuable people on the way. And so I kind of regret not being generous to myself about it. So just as another reminder, don't beat yourself over the co-op program. Well, that was everything you need to know about Waterloo's co-op system. If you have questions about anything that I talked about today, feel free to leave them in the comments and I will try my best to answer them. Thank you so much for watching. And if you want me to do another video about the University of Waterloo, please feel free to leave a comment. I hope to see all of you again soon. Bye.